Welcome to the physics class, students. Now, as we have seen in the previous lectures, what are the properties of the charges? What does stationary charge do? See, first we have seen that when the charge was stationary, two charges were attracting each other. That is Coulombian force, then potential by them, Gauss theorem, their electric fields. Then we came to the second stage of the charge when they started moving. So then when they started moving, then there came a new term known as electric current. That is the rate of flow of charge. Now, it is due to the motion of charge, something else is going to happen. See, suppose in this way, we take if there is a positive charge or a negative charge. It can be anything. And if this charge is moving, suppose it is moving in this direction, then it is observed that if a magnetic compass, suppose this is a magnetic compass, if this magnetic compass is placed near this moving charge, this is magnetic compass or magnetic needle, anything you can say. So, as this charge starts moving, then there is a deflection in this needle. But we all know that a magnetic needle can only be deflected when there is a magnetic field. So, it means that this moving charge, if suppose this charge is Q, then this means that this moving charge is creating or is producing a magnetic field. Okay, because of this moving charge, and as soon as the motion of this charge is stopped, the deflection in the needle also stops. So there was a scientist, Oster. So, Oster's experiment is there. In this experiment, he got this accidentally. Then what was discovered accidentally. But then he performed the experiment. So, what he did, he took a metallic wire and this wire was connected to a potential supply, that is a battery. So suppose this is a battery to which this wire is connected. Let it be a variable resistor over here in order to vary the intensity of the current. And let us keep one key so that we can put on and off this circuit. So, and beside this circuit, he kept a magnetic needle or magnetic compass. So, what he observed, as soon as this key is closed, the current starts flowing. I current starts flowing, then as soon as the circuit is turned on, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. He increases the current, so then he observed that the deflection was also increased. Then again what he did, he changed the polarity of this battery. That is, here he introduced a negative terminal and here a positive terminal. Then the polarity is changed, and this due to this changed polarity, the direction of the current is also changed. This will be the direction of the current. So now, if earlier this was the deflection, now in this case, when the direction of the current is changed, then the direction of deflection is also changed. And if the magnitude of the current was changed, then again it is seen that the deflection was increased a bit. So that means there are two things. From this experiment, it is concluded that moving charge or current produces magnetic field. One of the conclusions from this experiment. Second, the direction of magnetic field depends on direction of current flow. Okay, and the third point is that when all this is going to take place, then the intensity or the strength of magnetic field depends on amount of current, because as the current was increased, the deflection was also increased. And see, direction of the magnetic field depends on the direction of the current, strength depends on the magnitude of the current, and the moving charge produces a magnetic field. Okay, these are the conclusions drawn from this experiment, Oster's experiment. Okay, so this is a basic thing, that a moving charge produces a magnetic field. So the final or conclusion we can draw, that a moving charge produces magnetic field, okay, whose direction depends on the direction of current flow and magnitude depends on the amount of current flowing through it. Okay, and there was one more thing. As the compass was shifted away from the wire, away from this current carrying conductor, the deflection became feeble. The deflection was less. So you can also say that magnetic field also depends on distance from the wire or current carrying conductor. So these are the points which we draw from this experiment, or you can say this is the basic or introduction of the magnetic field due to moving charge. A magnetic field is produced due to a moving charge. Hope this concept is clear. If any kind of a doubt, please feel free to ask. Thank you.